Let's bring back the glory days in 400 meters for men.
Glory days? You have to go way, way back further than that for that.
Well, at least we'll win 4x4 medals.
Welcome, Sports Nation, to Sports DTM, the sports channel where we call sports down the middle. You can expect the latest in sports news, views, and reviews from our resident analysts. No sports topic is too controversial, and no team or player is above criticism. So just smash that subscribe button and ring that notification bell to make sure you don't miss out on our balanced offering of riveting sports content. And don't forget to like, share, and leave a comment below. Welcome to Sports DTM.
Greetings, Sports DTM fans, and welcome to another episode of Sports Down the Middle, your channel of undiluted sports content. Raymond, Adrian, and I are here to talk about the men's 400 meters. It has been a painful watch for many years now, 400 meters, and the track record is not so good. I know we can go way back from when we were in primary school to talk about glory days. But when we look at what is happening now, we're not even sure if them going to make the semifinals of the World Championship. And that is terrible. We have three men who will be taking part in the 400 meters individual race. Javon Powell, Christopher Taylor, and Nathan Allen. Powell's season's best of 44.87 place him 19th overall. I'm not sure if I should go into the ranking of the others, but Nathan Allen, his season's best of 45.21 place him 42nd overall. And then Christopher Taylor, his season's best 45.45. Placed him 79 overall. I don't think there'll be so many runners registered for the 400 meters for men. But Raymond, the last time we won a medal was way back in 2003. Michael Blackwood got a bronze medal. I mean, some of these runners probably weren't even born. And what we need to do to at least overachieve in this race?
Well, Kurt, the truth is, individually, it might not work out. So it's best to probably...
Or will not work out.
I like to use the might, because there are miracles. But... but I tend to shift to the relays and mix and the 4x4. You know, those are the things that we can probably look to get a medal in. If the thing that I can say, if persons do their personal best, that's a win for themselves and hopefully I look to better days ahead. That's what I'd say. So, you know, Christopher Taylor dipped below 45 seconds last year. Hopefully, he can better that, running probably 44.5 or, you know, going as close as possible to 43 and run another personal best. So things like that we have to look forward to and keep encouraging the athletes.
Adrian, when we were at the national trials and watching the 400 meters with the likes of Christopher Taylor, Cox, Bloomfield, Francis, and Allen, and there are some who never even made the finals that were running well, Bailey, Gay. We expected stiff competition with persons running fast. The winner was 45.5, and suddenly we realized that none of them don't meet the qualifying mark, right? But they managed to pick a team because Powell ran it earlier in the season. But I don't know how Christopher Taylor and Nathan Allen made the team. So if you can enlighten me with the way they made it on the team.
But Kurt, you're putting me on the spot. I mean, you're trying to allow me to unpack things which cannot be unpacked. But seriously, Javon Powell is the best placed Jamaican in 2022. But he's ranked number 19 in the world, right? You're talking about the likes of Michael Norman leading the way with FUD 3.56, which is almost a full 2 seconds better than the time.
It sounds like 2 minutes to me.
2 minutes, right? It does feel like 2 minutes. But the World Championship qualifying standards goes back to June 2021, I believe about the 27th of June, to the 26th, 12 months onward, to the 26th of June. Christopher Taylor would have run his fastest time during that period, Olympic time, at 44.79. So that would have made him be able to qualify. Likewise, of course, Javon Powell did his season best 44 below the 44.90 qualifying time as well. You'd have to get some more information to unpack Nathan Allen, of course, coming in there, because it's times that are just not good, but probably we have missed out on some other information. But he came second in the trials, which I suspect is works in his favor. But I've searched long and hard trying to find his qualifying time, and that's a challenge. But hey, you're picking amongst them, you're talking about the top six or seven athletes. The time between them was 0.41 seconds, from 45.50 to 45.91. That's a serious challenge. So what you can say about it, it was very competitive, extremely competitive from 1 to 7. But when you look at it in contrast, or try to match it up against where the rest of the world is, it's cheese to chalk. And that's a challenge for us.
Raymond, is it too much to ask for one of them to at least make the final, so that we can come out with some pad cover and beat them before the race?
Well, Christopher Taylor made the final last time round, so if he's able to run that personal best again and below, I can't see why he wouldn't make the finals. And that's all I really ask for him. You know, just keep improving. You know, another year, another improvement, another personal best. If you continue to do that, then you should be in the finals. And hopefully other Jamaican, you know, would see that and strive as well. So, yeah, I'm thinking that he should and could make the finals.
Adrian, what is our realistic objective for this crop of runners? I'm talking about the flat 400 now, not the relays. As we expect goal for the relays. I thought
you were hoping to win the right there, first
section. For the 400 only.
Yeah, the reality is, based on the numbers now, you're trying to sneak into the final, but you're way, way off the pace. Right now, they're probably pushing towards getting into the semifinals as a start, and you're hopeful that somebody will get a very good form to be able to clock in. But looking at the times of the top runners in the world at this point in time, it's going to take people dipping below 45 seconds to be able to make the top eight, or even get into even the semifinals at that. 45.50 isn't going to cut it. They are hopeful that the young men would have gone back to the drawing board since the trials and actually put in a lot of work to get them where they ought to be, because the current times that are there won't actually cut it.
Fans out there, let us hear from you. What's your thoughts on this crop of 400 meters runners, and what are your expectations of them over 400 meters? Our track record in 400 meters at the World Championship has been poor. In 2019, we had two runners who made the finals, and our best bet, Demish Gay, finished fourth, and Akeem dead last. In 2017, we had two runners as well who made the final, Allen, who is back, and Demish Gay, who didn't make the finals at Charles. In 2015, nobody never made the final. we have to go way back to 2003 for our last medal in 400 meters. The record at the World Championship, fans, is not so good. So let us hear from you what you think is the realistic objective or expectations of this group of players. Leave all those comments in the comment section below. And always remember to like, to share, and to subscribe. And to tell a friend, to tell a friend, to tell a friend, to tell all of them friends to come and join the Sports DTM family. This has been another episode of Sports Down the Middle. Raymond, Adrian, and I signing out. Be blessed.